Hello dear children, today let us begin with another grammar lesson, that is articles. So first let us have a look into a few sentences. I saw a bird. The bird was sitting in its nest, guarding an egg. The words a, an and the are termed as articles. So, there are mainly two kinds of articles. They are definite articles and indefinite articles. So, a and an are the indefinite articles, whereas the is called the definite article. Let us now first learn about the indefinite articles a and an. A and an are actually meaning the same, but A is placed before countable nouns, which are singular in number. For example, a boy, a bag, an egg, an ant. So these two articles, which are indefinite, are used only before the countable nouns. Countable nouns means which we can count, and singular nouns, which are only one. We do not put a or an before uncountable nouns which is in the singular form. For example, give me a sugar. This is wrong because sugar is uncountable. So we cannot put a before it. The next one is also of the same kind. She has an intelligence. This is a wrong sentence because intelligence is an uncountable noun yet in the singular form. So, we shouldn't use a or an before uncountables. Only it should be used before the countable nouns in the singular form. Let us all now have a look into the uses of a. We use a before the words which begin with a consonant sound. I hope you know what consonants are. All the letters except a, e, I, o, u are termed as consonants. For example, Meena is a student. Here you can see that A has been used before a consonant, that is S. And the next example is Mohan is a batsman. Here also you can see that B is a consonant and it has been used with A. We also write a one-eyed dog because since O is pronounced as W, when you pronounce one-eyed dog, it comes one, V, W sound comes. And you know that W is a consonant. So, in that case, it is an exception. We tell it as a one-eyed dog instead of an one-eyed dog. So, we write a utensil. Why? Because utensil, U, that is Y-O-U. It is pronounced as such. So, we have to say it as a utensil rather than an utensil. Let us now have a look into the uses of an. We use an before any word which begins with a vowel sound. That is, which have the sounds of a, e, I, o and u. For example, I have an apple for breakfast. An is used before apple because it has a vowel, a. It sounds also as a vowel. So, an has been used here. The next example is, I saw an eagle flying. An eagle. Here, an has been used before eagle because eagle has the sound of a vowel. We also write an honorable man, yet knowing that it starts with H and it should have A with it. But why do we use an? Because honorable, we don't tell it as honorable, it is honorable. So, O sound is coming here, which is a vowel sound. So, an has been used in this case. So, let us sum up whatever we have studied about a and an, the indefinite articles. An is used when we have countable and singular nouns, which begin with vowels. Whereas, a we use when we have countable and singular nouns, but which begin with consonant sounds. Always remember, an is used for vowel sounds and a is used for consonant sounds. Let us now move on to the definite article, the. We use a or an whenever we are talking about any person or anything. But it is completely opposite to the, which is a definite article. We use this when we are speaking about a particular person or thing. For example, give me a pen. It can be any pen, not a particular one. Whereas the second one is, give me the pen lying on the table. Here, we are specifying about the pen which we are talking about. That pen is lying on the table. So we have to use the when we are specifying about a particular pen. Whereas in the first case you had seen, we have written give me a pen. It could be any pen. But in the second case, we are telling it as give me the pen lying on the table. We are asking the pen which is particularly lying on that table. An important thing to remember here is, for any person or anything, we use a or an, the indefinite articles. Whereas, for any particular person or particular thing, we use the, which is a definite article. Let us now learn something more about a, an, and the. We use a or an, as told earlier, when we speak only about one person or one thing for the first time ever. But when we speak about them the second time or the third time or the succeeding times, we use the. For example, a man came to our school. In this sentence, you can observe that we are talking about any man. It is not particular and it is also for the first time. So we are using a before man. So the next example is, the man wanted to meet our principal. Why do we use the here? Because we are talking about a particular man who had come to our school and wanted to speak to our principal. So in this way, you have to form sentences. So a is usually used because it could be of any man and we are talking about that person for the first time. But if the same person is talked about for the second time, then we use the instead of the indefinite articles a or an. There are also times where we have not used a noun earlier. It is very clear that what we are talking about. In such cases also, we use the. For example, the television is switched on. In this case, we know that about which television we are talking. So we have used the. The same case, if we were not knowing about which television we are talking about, we would use a. The second example is, the window of the bedroom is broken. Here also we use the window and of the bedroom because we know which window and which bedroom we are talking about. Let us now know some facts on these articles. A or an is used for speaking of a person or a thing for the very first time, whereas the is used when we speak of them afterwards or sometime later in a paragraph or anywhere else. When the speaker and the listener know which person or thing is being speaking about, we use the. Whenever we know about whom we are speaking, we usually use the. Let us now have a look in some uses of the. The is mainly used with the names of rivers, seas, oceans, and mountain ranges. For example, the Ganges, the Red Sea, the Pacific Ocean, the Himalayas. As you all know that these are the names of rivers, seas, oceans, and mountain ranges respectively, the has been used for them. The next one is the names of well-known buildings. For example, the India Gate, the Taj Mahal, etc. have the before them because these are names of very well-known and famous buildings. Also, the names of holy books and newspapers also have the along with them. For example, the Gita, the Quran, the Statesman, the Hindu, the Deccan Chronicle, the Deccan Herald, all these are names of books, of holy books and newspapers respectively. They also have the definite article the before them. The names of trains, ships and aeroplanes are also having the along with them. For example, the Rajdhani Express, the Orient Express, these are all the name of trains and aeroplanes, and all these have the along with them. The name of some countries also have the. The name usually contain common noun have the with them. For example, the United States of America contains states, which is a common noun, and the United Kingdom also contains kingdom, which is a common noun. We also use the with the superlative degrees. I hope you all remember this. For example, the highest peak. Highest is an adjective which is in the superlative degree. The most intelligent student. This is also in the superlative degree, and we use the before it. The next one is, we use the in such phrases as the first, the last, the next, the only. So these are phrases which do not make complete sense. For example, he is the only son. This sentence also doesn't make any complete sense. So we use the along with it. That was the last time we met. It was also not a clear informative sentence. So we use the along with it. There are some restrictions also. The is not used with the following. With proper nouns. Proper nouns mean which nouns are specific or which are specific in nature and particular. So for example, the Sonali Sharma. This is wrong. The India. These are Sonali Sharma and India are proper nouns. Hence, the won't be used with proper nouns. With uncountable nouns that name materials. For example, the sugar, the iron, all these are uncountable nouns and material nouns. Uncountable nouns, as the name suggests, are the nouns which we cannot count. Whereas material nouns are those which gives us the name of the quality or material of a substance. For example, the sugar, as told earlier, and the iron are not suitable with the. Then qualities also are not suitable with the. For example, the honesty, the innocence, all these are wrong. The should not be used with proper nouns, uncountable nouns that name materials, and also those nouns which name some quality. But we use the with such nouns when they are made very particular. This is only for those material nouns. For example, I need sugar for making tea. Here we have not used any article with sugar because it is not required on the basis of the sentence. Please pass me the sugar in the jar. Here we are only talking about particular sugar which is present in the jar. Hence we tell it as the sugar. Let us now have a quick revision on whatever we have learnt in this session. A. It comes before countable nouns in the singular number beginning with the consonant sound, whereas the indefinite article an comes before the countable nouns in the singular number but beginning with a vowel sound, and the comes before the particular persons or things like moon, sky, titles of books, rivers, mountains, countries like UK, USA, etc. So always remember that indefinite articles are a and an, whereas the definite article is the. Dear children, I hope you have understood this lesson. Thank you.